Greetings, my friends. I'm doing 10,000 pull-ups to pie. I'm doing 10,000 pull-ups to pie. I'm just a normal guy who's doing 10,000 pull-ups to pie. Well, my friends, today is that pivotal day, that kind of, that benchmark, that whatever you want to call it. I don't know, the first goal. Is it the first goal? I don't know, but it's the halfway mark today. If we succeed today, which I'm, you know, I'm always quietly confident. There's a few days where I'm just like, oh, I'm not sure if I know their numbers, but you know, my head's a little bit, it feels a little bit battered today because I think I've drank about 5 cups of coffee or something. I'm kind of, I know it's not good. My head was like literally just buzzing. I'm like, what am I doing? But okay, so the mission to start with was to get 10,000 digits of pi in my little head. And doing the pull-ups, because I just love pull-ups. I think pull-ups, push-ups, dips, them things are just amazing things to do. Obviously sit-ups as well, you know, but I've been neglecting a few other things, I'll be honest. But anyhow, so today we're just going to continue on. We're on digit 4,901 to 5,000, the 5,000 mark. And we're just going to crack on, and I'm just going to talk as we're going, and then let's get it done. Okay, so here we go. Here we go, my friends. Oh, just stretching out a bit. Right. 6, 2, 2, 2, 4, 7, 7, 1, 5. We're off and running. There we go. Right, yes, there's quite a few two. 6, 2, 2, 2, 2. I like these type of ones. It would be better if it was 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, but you know, 6, 2 is fine. 4, 7, 7, 1, 5. Let's just get through this 50 and then we'll, you know, we'll start to have a little mini celebration. Might do a backflip. Yeah, I won't know. Right. Next one. Let's get it in your head. Let's do it. 4. No, actually, it's not. Let's reset that one. 8. 9, 1, 5, 0. Now it's 4, 9, 5, 3, 0. Okay, there we go. My God, that would be a disaster, wouldn't it? I'll tell you. Messing up on the big day. Okay, what did I say? 8, 9, 1, 5, 0. That's a bit close, isn't it? Anyhow, and 4, 9, 5, 3, 0. Okay, yeah, we've got a few collections of numbers coming up here. So, yeah, so 6, 2, 2, 2, 2 there, and the next few have got similar kind of vein, if that's the right thing, which is probably not. Okay, let's get in my head. 9, 8, 4, 4, 4, 8, 9, 3, 3, 3. I should have said, can you guess what the next one is? After my big clue. Okay, 9, 8, 4, 4, 4, 8, 9. Oh, actually, yes, that's reversed as well. Okay. 3, 3, 3. So it was good to remember some of these patterns, like 9, 8, 8, 9. You know, it's an extra little thing that you never know when you're going to need it when you're reciting pi. You know, which I'm sure you do all the time. Okay, right. Let's just shake it off, get the next ones in. I was saying I started with the Indiana Jones movies, so this is Raiders of the Lost Ark. So I'm going through the scenes in my head right now, so I'm using them as locations. So, should I tell you now? I'll get through it, man. I just keep stopping myself, and then we'll talk about it. Right, back to the beginning. Ooh. 0, 9, 6, 3, 4. 0, 8, 7, 8, 0. That was a zero there, by the way, at the end. 0, 9, 6, 3, 0, 9, 6, 3, 4, that's it, yes. And 0, 8, sorry, I'm just there. 0, 8, 7, 8, 0. Okay, let's make that into 8. Yeah, I know you can't see the board. I'll bring the board forward once I've done the 100, so you can see the digits. Right. Okay. Just want to kind of get it in my head where I am. 7, 6, 9, 3, 2, 5, 9, 9, 3, 9. Okay. 7, 6, 9, 3, 2, and 5, 9, 9, 3, 9. Okay. Let's see how we're getting on. Yes, we seem to be, that's the first stage done, my friends. This is good. Yeah, so like I was saying, I started yesterday was my first day of using scenes from Raiders of the Lost Ark. And I've done the first two movies and I've took the pictures and I've placed the numbers on. So in my little book here, down here, I've got all the 10,000 digits written out, and I've got up to 7,000. Actually, I don't want to open the book and look because you might think I'm cheating there, but I've got up to 7,000 written out at like the locations and things and the numbers next to them. So I'm almost up to that. I've kind of memorized 6,700, I believe now. Although, again, I'm finding that some of these things, especially, I still need to get better at actually going back over the ones that I've previously learned. It is quite hard. Obviously, the more numbers I get, the harder it is to keep spinning them plates and going back. Because even the ones at the beginning, I'm sure they're starting to fade, some of them. I think some of them are really locked in there. But I've got no doubt as well that once I get this done and I start going through everything again, even the ones I forgot will come back, and then I literally don't need to learn anymore. So basically I'll be get them in my head. I don't know how long that'll take, but I might even like spend a few days after I've done it just purely kind of pie and just kind of going like the full days, just going through everything, getting them in my head, and then start to deploy another system after the kind of, we'll see though. This is, again, I've never done this before, so it's, I'm sure most of you haven't, you know. But anyhow, so Indiana Jones, so this particular station is when he's leaving. So he's got the, what do you call it? The gold statue thing. I can't think of what it might be called. But anyhow, so then he's got that now, and then he's leaving and he's diving under the door, which is coming down again. Because that guy betrayed him, you know, and he had to throw him the amulet, let's just call it that. The idol, that's the one. He had to throw him the idol. And he had to jump over the big hole, you know, the one that he swung across to start with. Anyhow, so this one starts when he's diving through, so he's dove through the gate, the door, and he's gone back to grab his hat, okay? And this one is Sean Bean. So 6-2, yeah, I'll quickly go through. So I convert the numbers into letters. 0 is O, 1 is A, 2 is B, 3 is C, 4 is D, 5 is E, 6 is S, 7 is G, 8 is H, and 9 is N. I turn them letters into the characters, and I have the person, then the person also has an action, and then I don't quite, I have them as an object, but that's not fully, this is what Nelson Dellis uses, but really I've just got the person in the action right now. The object can be part of the thing that they use for the action, but I haven't really gone through them yet, because the last digit I use here is just a number shape or a number rhyme. So as an example, so let's have a look. So 09, well, I guess I could use Sean Bean, because S is 6 and 2 is B. So Sean Bean from Sharp, have you ever watched that TV series? I actually haven't really watched it, but I've seen a clip. And he's like, you know, he swears quite a bit, so he's kind of like swearing this. And 22 is Brian Blessed, so I use him from the Flash Gordon, where he's got the wings, where he's like the Birdman. So Sean Bean's got the wings on him, so he's flying through the door. And again, 2 also represents bird, because it looks a bit like a bird, so you can have either number shape or number rhyme. So 2 could be, if you're rhyming it, it could be shoe. So you could just be wearing some really fancy shoes or something, so you exaggerate these things. Or 2 looks a bit like a bird. So anyhow, that's kind of what I use for that. So like a swan or something, you know. So anyhow, so it can be any bird. Sometimes I used big giant eagles, sometimes I just have a flock of birds attacking vultures, it could be anything. So anyhow, that's what he's doing. In the next one, where the guy is actually being stabbed in a thing, so then it's, what do you call him? I forget his actual name now. I can see his hair, I can see he's from the Lethal Weapon film, Danny Glover, thank you. Thank you. So I almost always have his action is sitting on the toilet from the Lethal Weapon films. He was sitting on the toilet, which was had the bomb on it. So that's always the action. So if someone is got 47, then they're sitting on the toilet. So yeah. So that's Gillian Anderson, 71. So her action is kind of being chased by aliens from the X-Files. They kind of go like this. You hear the music in your head. And you do the X-Files thing, and then aliens come about in the chase, yeah, or in whatever way you want to have them. And then the last one on that one is 5, which is a snake. So he's sitting on the toilet, and Danny Glover, and the guy's being pierced with a thing, and then, which is an alien, because it's Gillian Anderson there, and then out of the head, a big snake comes out. Anyhow, that's kind of how I do, and I play some, how I do it, and I play some all on locations as I'm going. So that this one, 49530, that's when the ball is starting to chase them out. And then 98444 is when they dive out of the actual cave. Anyhow, I'm waffling on too much. Let's crack on with the next ones. I'll just see where I am in my head. And then let us begin. Oops. Let's have a look. 7, 8, 0, 5, 4, 1, 9, 3, 4, 1. Okay, there we go, off and running. So that was a bit long-winded there, I apologise. 7, 8, 0, 5, 4, 1, 9, 3, 4, 1. Okay. Right. 4, 4, 7, 3, 7 and 7, 4, 4, 1, 8. Okay. 4, 4, 7, 3, 7, 7, 4, 4, 1, 8. Okay. That's Gina Davis is leaving the flying out on the plane to escape, and Indy gets in the cockpit and there's a big snake there. But Gina Davis is in there from, she's got a baseball bat from League of the Own or whatever it was called. And she's doing the action of Dan Aykroyd, so from the Ghostbusters. So she's got a big Ghostbuster pack and she's like shooting it at the snake. But it's snowing as well, it's snowing on the outside. That's what 8 represents, because it looks like a snowman. So anyhow, right. So they're leaving the plane there now, and now they're back to the university. So the next thing is outside of the university. where Indy's doing the professor thing. Okay. 4, 2, 6, 3, 1, 2, 9, 8, 6, 0. 4, 2, 6, 3, 1, and 2, 9. Kind of works out quite well, this one, because 2, 9 is Bill Nye, science guy. So Indy's writing on the board, and 8, 6 here is actually Han Solo, so it's Harrison Ford. So it kind of, in 0, he's actually on this particular one, he's actually writing Neo on the board, probably for Neolithic or something, I don't know. And then, so the O represents the O there. So, anyhow, yeah. It's just like little extra little links that you can latch on to your brain, my little brain. Okay. 8, 0, 9, 9, 8, 0, 9, 9, 8, 8, 8, 6, 8, 7. Okay. 8, 0, 9, 9, 8, 8, 8, 6, 8, 7. Lots of eights. Okay. Final two, my friends, and then we are there. I just walk out now and that's it. I'm just like, I'm done with pie. Ain't doing it. Ain't doing it no more. Okay. Okay. All right. 4, 1, 3, 2, 6, 0, 4, 0, 4, 7, 2, 1. Man, feeling weak. Okay. What did I say? What did I say? 41, 32, 6, and 0, 4, 7, 2, and 1. There we go. I've got the numbers quite close to that, but anyhow, let's see how we're getting on here. Okay. I believe we've done it, my friends. I believe we've got to the halfway mark. Drum roll. Sorry, just falling over there. honestly, that was coffee and not whiskey I was drinking earlier. So there you go, if you can see that. Then, I'm sure you can. Let's just think of it. Oh God, he's dropped the pen. Oh my, that's it. Back to the beginning, my friends. All the way back to the start. Whew. There you go. It's, you know, I thought I'd feel more of a buzz of excitement there, but I guess I'm just dead inside. but yeah, so it was good, you know what I mean? Obviously at the beginning, that's how life works, doesn't it? It just goes forward. You start something. I always remember as a kid, kind of, you know, when we're gonna go on holiday, for instance. So it was like, you know, in the summer, we're gonna go to Spain for a couple of weeks. And I remember, like, say in November, and I'm just excited. I'm looking through the brochures at the pool and the heat and things. I'm all excited. I'm like, that's like miles away. It's like 6, 7 months away before we go. And I'm like, it'll never come. But then it comes. And then all of a sudden, 40 years have gone. And I'm like 51 in a few weeks. And I'm like, oh, okay. So it's the same as the pie. You know, I mean, I know that's a strange analogy in a way. But yes, so I started. We're halfway through, and let's just double that time, and then I'll be all the way through. And I might be on my knees, I might have arms in plasters or something, I don't really know, but we're just going to continue, and we'll get through there, and I'm kind of finding it. I'm not gonna say hard, because it's obviously it's not easy to do all these things, and it takes time and it takes effort, and obviously when we're trying to do other things as well, it depends how far you want to take this. If I wasn't doing this, to do on camera and do it in this time period of the Monday to Friday, I'm so glad I didn't actually say to do it every day. That would have been problematic, to be honest. I'm glad it's only Monday to Friday. It gives us that breathing space to try and absorb the more that I've learned each week. Because again, I'm trying to learn an extra 300 or 400 each week to keep up. So I'm ahead of the game all the time. But obviously I've got to keep going back and learn these things. I know I mentioned this a bit, but obviously this is about pie and pull-ups and things, you know, and life, the universe, everything. But yeah, it's disappointing if I lose what I've put the effort into. I'm sure we've all put massive effort into things, and then for some reason we've either stopped, or we just haven't caught in time, or we lose the excitement for it, and then it just, you know, pitters away. That's not the word again, but you know, I always come up with the wrong word, but you know, what can I say? It's live, I'm doing it live as well on the Facebook, so I can't just stand here all day going, what's the perfect word for that? I don't know. But it's so, like, for instance, this week, I've only learned about 300 this week. But when I went back before as well, there was some of them, I think I just learned it once or twice a few days ago. And again, I've just been quite busy, and I didn't reinforce it. So again, it wasn't fully formed. But when I went back through the week, I was like, on some of the stages, I was like, I couldn't remember it all. I'm just going through, I'm like, what was that? I was like, was it that one? And obviously it is, because that's what it's written down as. But again, like I said, I'm really trying my best to kind of to do this in the best type of way. And I've still got half of them to go, which is good. In that time as well, I'm really going to try and develop and nail down a really good system, so that by the end of it as well, it'll be really useful to pass it on to everybody who wants to learn this. You know, the best systems that I've worked out, that I think, you know, and again, we're all individuals, all our brains work differently, so some people will absorb these things a lot faster. But again, 10,000 is a lot of numbers. And again, if I didn't have to learn this many, then I might drag it out over years, to be honest with you. I might just learn. But in a way, sometimes, you know, it's just good to get it done, whatever it is, rather than dragging it out. But I don't know. Anyhow, so I'm absolutely certain in my mind, I am 100% confident. I'm not going to leave any wiggle room there, that I will be able to memorize the full 10,000. Again, but once I've finished it, whatever the percentage of recall I'll have right there, it might only be 80% or something. But the rest will be in there, because I would have gone through them so many times that once I capture them again, they'll be more solidified. And then when I don't have to keep learning them, then I might spend a few days just going through the whole lot again. Then once I've done that, then I'll maybe be systematic each day and make sure I do 1,000 a day, you know, throughout the day. You know, kind of every hour, or every hour and a half, just do another 100, do 1,000 on that day, then just keep on reciting it, and then till they're absolutely in my head. And that's when I'll start doing all these other things, like the world record attempt that I was talking about. That could be, I don't know when that'll be. That'll be when I'm ready for it, to be honest with you. That's where I memorize. That's where basically the challenge is, the ask you on the world record board, whoever would actually do this, they will ask you any number, any block of five within the 10,000, and you've got to tell them what the previous five is and the five after. So you can imagine you've got to know these things inside and out, and I'm nowhere near that. Obviously, for a start, I don't have the 10,000 in my head. Then I've got to get them so kind of there for the recall that I'm able to do this. So that's another test. But this is just, and I don't want to slack off as well. I don't want to be like, do all this work and then just not do the work if after, and then let it all fade. That's not what I want to do. I want to kind of double down almost. And so anyhow, I am waffling on a bit more here, because I feel like it's the 5,000 kind of number. So, you know, I feel like I just need to kind of give an extra speech. I know, friends, open to countrymen, lend me your ears. I come here to bury Caesar, not to praise him. The evil of men do live after them. The good is often turned in their bones. So let be with season. Anyway. You know, a bit of Shakespeare from the Pondering Pie guy. Okay, my friends, that will do for today. We made it halfway, so hey, let's continue. Let's just double down, literally double down, and get the other 5,000 done. Okay, have a great weekend, my friends. I'll see you next week. Bye bye. Okay, there we go. Had no live viewers there, my YouTube friends. I was all alone. Oh, so sad. Why doesn't everybody love me? All I want to be is loved. Okay, there we go. Let's see if we're still running. We are for a few minutes, but yes. So yeah, it's exciting times. I'll do a little dance. I can't see myself now, so I don't know what I look like. I'm sure I look splendid. But yeah, I'm actually going out today as well, because today's like the Cheltenham horse racing event. I don't even go out that much now. I go out like once a month, because I'm on a mission to just try and get my art sorted and all that other stuff. So we'll pop out this afternoon in about 3 hours. I don't have a watch, I don't know what I'm doing. Just a few drinks, I don't drink that much. And a flutter on a few horses. Hopefully if I break even, I'll be over the moon. But yes, but we'll be back next week for day 51 and the road home. I still haven't decided, I'm still continuing up the mountain and coming down. I think I'm doing both at the same time in my mind. Anyway, have a great weekend, my friends. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.